week on In Conversation with Front of Stage, we've got the amazing Jess Widdup with us. Jess is a singer-songwriter who just recently graduated from BIMM University and received her degree in professional musicianship. She's also one of our closest friends.
Jess is also part of the Front of Stage team and regularly helps by contributing ideas and blocks.
Can't wait to, you know, get in chatting with Jess.
It's going to be good.
Hi, hey. Jess. We're so happy to have you here in our first ever series of In Conversation with Front of Stage. How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. Thank you for letting me join you guys for the first one. It's exciting to be here.
No worries at all. So, do you want to get started with the first question?
Okay, so would you like to tell us a little bit about your background in music?
So I've been performing as a actor slash musician from a young age. So I was involved in a lot of musical theatre when I was a kid. I used to do like Oliver, Wizard of Oz. And then throughout like primary school and high school, I was playing, dabbling in various instruments. So I did a bit of violin, done a bit of piano, a bit of guitar. But my main instrument is my voice. So, and then throughout, again, high school, I was involved in all the plays, involved with, like, any sort of musical performance. I would, like, get involved with various bands and do a couple of songs with them, or I'd do, like, some instrumental stuff, like, solo performances or duets with other singers. So I've always been a performer, always been, like, involved in music, dance and drama. And then decided to study music at BIMM.
So would you say it was like musicals that got you involved in it and brought your attention to begin with?
Yeah, because like, I think when I was really young, so when I was like 5 and under, I was quite a dramatic child. Mm-hmm. So my mum decided that she wanted me to put that into something. And so she took me to like various different like plays. I did like auditions for being an extra in like Hollyoaks or adverts and stuff. But I think like it was just a way of me channeling my creativity, and then I just sort of got more involved with the music side, started listening to more bands, which made me want to do like more music things.
So you've just always been around it.
Yeah, definitely.
So as you mentioned, you recently just graduated from BIMM, so congratulations on that. But was your university experience? Like, would you recommend it for other people in the industry?
That's a tough one. So I would definitely check it out. It's not for everyone because I did my foundation year and I absolutely adored that. I was with the right group of people. Everything was perfect. We'd all go around to each of us houses. We'd do like harmonious nights where we'd like just chill and make music. And then, so I did my foundation year in London. And then I moved to Manchester and I did my first and second year. And I felt a bit more out of it because I was a bit older than some of the other people in the groups. And I wasn't living within student accommodation, which also felt a bit weird. So it's the experiences that I've gotten from being at uni has been useful and worthwhile. But I feel like if I'd have gone back, I probably wouldn't have gone to uni, but that's my personal opinion. I probably would have tried to have branched out into something a bit different. I would have tried to start doing more gigs because I felt like university took up a lot of my time. Mm-hmm. Whereas now I'm free, I'm like doing a lot more practicing with singing and like hoping to do a lot more gigging and stuff. Okay. So it's all personal opinion.
At least you've got that now to fall back on, which is really good, your degree.
Yeah.
So definitely. Where do you want to go from here?
As I just said, I want to be able to start recording, maybe. I've got some basic recording equipment. So my dissertation that I did was all about recording equipment, comparing home studios to commercial studios. So that's given me like a really good base on how to build my own like sort of home studio. So at the moment, I'm in the process of like making that room up. And then hopefully from there, I'll start writing my own music, maybe. And then hopefully start gigging.
That sounds really exciting.
Super exciting. How would you describe your sound?
So my sound, it can be quite classic. So it's quite a clean sort of Adele vibe. But I do like to do my rock music. So I can do stuff like Hailstorm to Queen to like more emo sort of sound like Paramore. But my voice is quite clean, quite clear, so it's usually like quite singer-songwriter.
Yeah, no, I'm a big fan
of your
voice.
We love your voice. Yeah. Who would you most like to collab with if you could collab with anyone?
Oh, Brendan Urie.
Good yeah.
I like it.
He just has such a range on his voice and such a range of different styles that he could do. I reckon it would just be like insane working with him.
I'd love to watch that.
Yeah, no, me too. So what are your musical inspirations and influences, would you say?
So when I was younger, a lot of Queen, Fleetwood Mac, so a lot of like your old school rock, so like also like AC/DC and Metallica. And as I grew older, in my teenage years, it was more like Paramore and people like Panic at the Disco and Fall Out Boy. And then now here, one of my biggest inspirations is a singer from Hailstorm. She's called Lizzie Hale. She has an insane voice, and that's sort of like something I aspire to sort of get to.
Awesome.
Why American? Do you have any really good advice? Like, what's the best advice you've been given?
Breathe. Everything's about the breathing. So nervous, breathe. Feel like you can't hit the right notes, do some breathing exercises. It's all about the lungs. Being able to control your breath is the base of everything.
I think that'll help a lot of people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, that's really, we got to know you a lot more, I think.
Yeah. Great. Next up is Jess performing She Used To Be Mine from the musical Waitress. Jess recently recorded this for her dissertation.
We absolutely love this, don't we?
Yeah, it's one of my favourites.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you guys are going to love it too.
It's not simple to say. Most days I don't recognize me. These shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true was never attention, sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken, won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. Life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's so true. Now I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over.
question time. This part is all about speed.
We're going to ask you some questions which you need to answer super fast so those at home can get to know you a little bit better.
Are you ready?
Kind of, yes, ready.
Music crush.
Music crush. Mm-hmm. Oh shit. Taylor Morrison.
Babe boy band.
NSYNC.
A girl band.
Girls Aloud.
Do you have a party trick? And if so, what?
I don't.
Oh, we need to get you on. The first CD you ever bought, if you can remember.
It wasn't one I bought, but it was one I was given, and it was a Girls Aloud CD. It was their first one.
What is your favourite movie?
Any of the Lord of the Rings.
Favourite musical?
Wicked.
Pepsi or Coke?
Pepsi.
Indian or Chinese?
Indian.
Dog or cat?
Cat.
Summer or winter?
Summer.
Woo!
We did it.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us. It's been great getting an insight into yourself and your music, and we're so excited to see what's going to happen next with you.
Thank you so much. This has been really fun. I've enjoyed being on your show. Especially love the fact that I'm the first one. Thank you.
Thank you for everyone for listening and watching. It's been great. We're your hosts, Becky and Sammy, and this is In Conversation with Front of Stage.
Woo!